This next segment highlights some interesting artifacts at the new permanent exhibit at the Guam Museum. Half a day, we're here at the new permanent exhibit at the Guam Museum, where we're going to take you back on a journey 3,500 years ago to what Guam's culture was like way back in the day when we were still evolving to what we know now. So come on, let's check it out. The exhibit features 6 different installments, and of these, we decided to focus on the 2 that featured the oldest artifacts and the Taga Man. So to start off our journey, I'm here with Alex, our docent here at the new exhibit, and he's going to tell us, of these cool artifacts we have here, which would be the oldest?
Our oldest got to be the beads. They date back to in between 900 to 400 BC.
That's almost 3,000 years ago.
Our ancestors settled in shoreline communities that provided a stable supply of shellfish and other resources. Shells found at these sites were used as jewelry to reflect status, gifts, and as a form of currency during trade. Both men and women had different kinds of jewelry to reflect status or achievement. Spondylus shells were more typical of women, while the hawksbill turtle shell were worn by men.
So in this case, we have different pottery shards and reconstructed vessels from different time periods. And Alex is going to tell us the different periods that we see and what these pottery shards used to be used for.
Yeah, so pre-Latty pottery shards are more of thinner and flat. Rather than Latty period, it's more of a ball kind of shape. Pre-Latty period has more of the designs, and it dates back down to 1500 BC to 980, and then Latty period is more dated back to 980 to 1780.
So definitely pre-Latty would be the older shards, and that particular shard is the oldest in the museum?
Yes, found in Aton Beach.
So aside from the ancient artifacts that we've seen already, we also have the ancient remains of the Taga Man, and Alex is going to tell us a little more about it.
Yeah, the Taga Man was dated around 500 to 800 years old when it was found in the Taga site in Tinian. So in 1998, Saipan National Museum, who lent it to us, they reconstructed it in 1998. It dated back to when he supposedly died around his mid-50s.
And it also says here that he was stabbed in the face.
Yeah, that was dated in his younger days. There's an official scarring on his skull, but it's supposed to be healed. Yeah, you can see right here.
Well, this Taga Man has a story behind him. He's probably a rough and tough fighter, and he sustained that wound and lived into his 50s. And now we have his skull here, and we can actually press this button and see what he might have looked like. He looks like my uncle.
There are so many fun and interactive ways to learn about Guam's history at the new permanent exhibit.